entire life. As a child, he hunted for food in the mountains, fished the rivers. Rivers were coming in, mountains were full of game. And he's lived long enough to see that the rivers get polluted from being dumped in by industrial waste. And he saw his beautiful mountains become real estate to developers. So Doc is going to tell us stories of from then until now. Doc Morgan, Mud Turtle.
Mud Turtle.
Mud Turtle.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, my walk has been tall. It took a while to get that way. But I come from New Jersey. Lifestyle and everything as a child growing up is beautiful. The mountains was gorgeous. The trapping was gorgeous. The hunting was gorgeous. Our people were gorgeous. And as time changes and you grow out of that childhood, you look in reality dead in the face. I walk tall. I stand tall, and any negativity that comes in front of me, especially if I don't understand it, I know how to turn my back on it. Yeah? And you might even hear it in your terms, you know, Satan, get behind me. You know, because I can't deal with it. Yeah? Because once you leave this earth, there's no everybody says, oh, we're going to go to this wonderful golden forest, and maybe we will. I believe we're going to go to a better place. Because I think the bickering back and forth through life, this is a devil's world. And if you don't believe it, look what's going on there. Look what was taken away from the Native Americans. That was the only people here, right? And with love and open arms, I'm like, oh, come here, you know. Eat some of our corn, do this, do that, you know. And they found out that we had a little silver, we had a little gold, we had a lot of love, you know. They took advantage of the women, they took the gold, they took the silver. Next thing you know, you're off of your reservation. And they put you over here, oh, okay, you know, we got to do this because we don't want our people killed. They put it on land with the oil bubbling up out of the ground. And then the same people that moved you from that land goes over here now and says, oh no, this is not good for you, you got to move. Right? And they did that until we were almost all extinct, right? And then you go down into Florida, the Seminoles, they're the only nation that has never signed a treaty with this country, right? They refused to sign their treaty. When the people went into the Everglades, chased the Indians back until they were at, say, 5 million, wind up being 5,000. So they go to other nations and they pick up other nations' women. So when you say somebody say, oh, I'm Mohawk and Muncie or I'm Lenape and Muncie, you know, that's the shake and bake that came through the chain. That not our chain, but the chain that we was forced to keep our heritage, to keep our bloodline. You know? I hope and see people at some of the powwows where you could come and stand and look at a powwow circle and see all of the workers. See the joy, listen to the music. And at the end of the ceremony, at the end of the powwow, we all get in that circle and we just bum rush the drummers. And then they want to call us heathens. That's the time we're heathens. Because we'll chant on one foot, we'll spin, we'll shout. And, people go, you just spit on me, that's all you can do. Just get singing in our native songs, which are beautiful. When you beat that drum, when you open your mouth, your soul comes out to play. And heaven smiles down at you. Because a little while ago here, all of a sudden my leg started like, you know, oh no. You know, they called me Jitterbug when I was a kid, you know. Twinkle toes and all of that because I like to dance. And, but even now when I heard the drum, you know, it started moving in certain ways, you know. Life is love. You know, enjoy this life that is given to us. And if you find a neighbor that needs a helping hand, there's nothing wrong going over there and helping. don't look for anything in return because the Creator will reward you so much better than you'll ever, ever receive in life. You know? Like I said, when I went and give my last dollar away, and I'm going away going like, boy, you talk about an idiot, you know? And my mother always said, yeah, the Creator will take care of you. Even a couple of times, I'm like, well, Creator, I'm still waiting. He don't give it to us when we want it. He, you know, he gives it to you when he wants you to have it. And the time he gives it to you, it's needed for so many other things that you really can't go and blow this. Right? Oh, man, you know, Sister Rita needs something, or Brother Grant needs something. As we walk through this life, though, please respect each other and just show a little bit of love, and that will grow. And like when I met you, right? You were a child. You walk with me, you grow fires with me, you help me getting grapevines, you know, as a child. And to see you sit here today, and to see you on the drum, you know, you brought joy tears to my eyes.